Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you for coming this presentation. I'm glad to see you all. My name is Amri Dunan from the Ministry of Communication and Informatics, Jakarta, Indonesia. In this opportunity, I would like to present my paper in for ICOSA 4. My paper entitled The Challenge of Communicating Pancasila Values in the Millennial Generations in Indonesia. The internet has become an important medium in the dispersion of the Islamic doctrine of radicalism and intolerance, which not only made university students as targets, but students as well. The characteristic of radicalism can be seen from the intolerant behavior and attitudes towards groups which disagree. Some of the previous studies on public opinion regarding Pancasila are as follows: the Indonesian Survey Circle Survey LSI, Deni JA, 2018 shows within certain years the pro-Pancasila public have decreased by 10%. The Alfara Research Center survey 2018 shows 18.4% of students agree that the Khalifat is the ideal form of a country. And then a survey by the Sirius Network Survey Institute 2019 shows there are 11% of respondents who wanted Indonesia to apply the Islamic Sharia. And then the research question: what is the information communication strategy and education implementation of Pancasila values among the millennial generations? Based on the research questions above, the purpose of this study is to identify an effective information communication strategy and implementation of Pancasila values among the millennial. Here's methodology. A qualitative inductive approach with a constructivist paradigm is used in this study. Data collection was carried out by means of focus group discussion, FGD, interviews, and literature study. FGDs were held 4 times by presenting resource persons from Pancasila Ideology Development Agency, influencer, and then academics, millennials, and from the Directorate General of Public Communication Information, PCI, of the Ministry of Communication and Informatics. Interviews were also conducted with youth activists, influencers, and officials from the Director General of PCI to obtain more in-depth and comprehensive data. This study uses grounded theory method in the process of data collection and data analysis by doing Excel and matrix coding. The matrix is used to make comparison between the current condition and the expected condition after categorizing the data and analyzing the data. Triangulation of data source was carried out for data validation and continue with drawing conclusion. Here, funding and discussion, communication, information, and education strategies for the implementation of Pancasila values in the millennial generation. On aspect communication, current condition, two-way communication, asymmetrical. The public sphere is full of hoax and hate speech. The millennial generation is less involved. And then in expected condition, two-way communication symmetrical, creating healthy public sphere, engagement of the millennial generation. And then information aspect, lack of digital literacy, the existence of Pancasila jargon's content packaging is less attractive, sporadic in the public sphere in current condition. And then in expert condition, extending digital literacy, practical in nature, content packaged attractive, systematic structure and massive manner. In education aspect, current condition, Pancasila values education no longer will fill the public sphere. The existence of school and campus mounts as a channel to recruit the qualified supporters. And then in expected condition, the education of Pancasila values starts from early childhood. They must be stopped and declare illegal, recruit the qualified supporter. So the conclusion, the development of communication, information, and education strategy for the implementation of Pancasila values among millennials in Indonesia has various challenges in implementing communication, information, and education on the values of Pancasila. It is hoped to be able to create a healthy public sphere by involving the millennial generation in the Pancasila campaign program. This two-way communication between the government and the public. In this case, the millennial generation can be realized in a balanced way and with mutual influence. Obviously, by expanding the digital literacy of Pancasila values in a continuous, structured, and massive manner. It is hoped Pancasila narrative does not have the character of federalism or mere activism, but in a practical form. The packaging of Pancasila values in the form of video graphics should be in the content preferred by the current millennial generation. While Pancasila values education can start from early childhood in the family, so as in the end, it can fulfill and nourish the public sphere from various hoaxes and hate speech. That's all my presentation. Thank you for the attention. Thank you.